every operation at the test site is the control point at Yucca Pass, overlooking both Frenchman and Yucca Flats. From it radiate the myriad communication lines required to control such a complex operation. Into and out of it flows information from all over the world, as well as from other areas of the test site itself. The instrument panel in the control room reflects these intricate operations. Control of experiments is provided by a sequence timer located here. This device transmits signals which activate electronic systems, secure blast-proof doors, start ultra-fast cameras, and in some cases, arm and fire the device itself. These and hundreds of other details must be taken care of in proper order and at precise times if the necessary data is to be obtained. As H-hour approaches, night weather briefings by test site meteorologists are conducted for unit project officers.
Gentlemen, that seems to be the picture as of the moment. With regard to your operation, prospects for fallout within the Nevada test site and the adjacent bombing and gunnery range are good. The winds, as they are now, will result in very little off-site fallout. If the winds maintain their present direction, and this, I'm sure, will make you flyboys happy, the fallout should pass directly over station marker number 2. Any questions? Okay, good night. Happy fallout, honey.
Everyone has waited for this moment. Now, an actual situation is in the making. A situation that, barring enemy attack, cannot be duplicated anywhere in the United States. Everything that has gone before, the careful planning, development of techniques, and review of procedures, has led to this. All along the line, the units begin to function. The RADEF chief and operations officer reevaluate their fallout prediction based on the latest weather information. Communications are established between the radiological control center and the operating units in the field. Every man, every unit, in proper position. Then, the long wait, before the final minute is counted off. Of the sun, the awesome sound and fury of the atoms split apart. This is nuclear explosion. High above the desert, the atomic cloud hangs until wind begins to scatter it. Already, tiny radioactive fission products adhering to debris are starting to fall. Within the hour, the largest will reach the ground. Later, when on-site fallout has occurred, monitors of the permanent RadSafe unit penetrate the shot area. Once the fallout field has been surveyed and the level of radioactivity certified as being within permissible limits, the test groups may begin their exercises.